Hey guys, welcome back to the data science course. And in today's session, we'll learn and implement multiple linear regression. So let's get started. So in multiple linear regression, we have more than one independent variable, and we try to determine how do all of these independent variables together affect the dependent variable. Like over here, we have a mapping between y, x1, x2, and x3, where y is the dependent variable, and x1, x2, and x3 are the independent variables. So let's take this example to have a better understanding of multiple linear regression. So over here, we are trying to understand what factors affect the salary of an employee. Here, salary is the dependent variable, and gender, age, and department are the independent variables. So this linear regression model helps us to determine the salary of an employee when specific values are given to age, gender, and department. So let's go to RStudio and implement multiple linear regression. Right, we have our studio right in front of us, and this is our same old customer churn data set. Alright, so now since we already know that before building a linear regression model, we need to divide our data set into training and testing sets. And to do that, we would require the CA tools package. So I'll type library of CA tools. So we have loaded the CA tools package. So now to build the linear regression model, I will take the tenure column as the dependent variable. And I'll try to understand how do other columns affect the tenure of a customer, right? So I'll split this data set with respect to the tenure column. So I will use the sample.split function. Now let me select this column, customer churn dollar tenure, right? And the split ratio which I'll be giving is 0.65, and I will store this in an object called as split model. Okay, so basically 65% of the observations would get true values, and the rest 35 observations would get the false values. So now that we've stored this result in split model, I will divide the data set using the subset function. Right, so now this takes in the first parameter as the data set. Now from this data set, wherever the value of split model is equal to true, I will store all of those observations in the training set. Right, similarly from the entire customer churn data set, wherever the value of split model is false, I'll select all of those observations and I will store those observations in a data set called as test. And thus we have our training and testing sets ready. Now let me just have a look at the number of rows in training and testing. So n row of train is 4573 and n row of test is 2470. Right, so we have our training and testing sets ready. Now it's finally time to build a linear regression model. So I'll use the LM function. So the dependent variable is tenure, and the independent variables are monthly charges. Then we have gender, following which we have internet service. Then the final independent variable is contract. So we are trying to understand how does tenure vary with respect to monthly charges, gender, internet service, and contract. And the data would be train. That is, on top of the train set, we are building this linear regression model. And I will store this in an object called as mod1. Right. So we have built our multiple linear regression model. Now it's time to predict the values on top of this model, and to do that I will use the predict function, right? Predict. So the first parameter which it would take is the model which you just built. So mod1. Next is the testing set on which we'd want to check the accuracy of the model. Okay, so I've given both of the parameters, and I'll store the result in, let's say, result1. Now, I will bind the actual values and the predicted values into a common data set. I'll use the cbind function. Now, let me take the original values. So, the original values would be this tenure column from the test set, and the predicted values would be the value stored in result1 object. So, I will name this column as actual, and I will name this column as predicted. Right. And I will store this in a new object with the name of final data one. Okay. So let me have a glance at this view of final data one, right? So these are the actual values of the tenure and these are the predicted values of the tenure, which we are able to predict with the help of the predict function, right? So thus we have predicted the values with the help of the linear regression model. Now we'll go ahead and find out the accuracy. Again, to find out the accuracy, first we need to find out all of the residuals. Then we need to find out the root mean square error. So let's go ahead and find out the error in this, right? So now before that, since this is actually a matrix, I need to convert this into a data frame. So I'll use as.dataFrame function and I will convert this into a data frame. I'll store the result back to the same set, final data one. Right, so now this is actually a data frame, right? So now I will subtract the predicted values from the actual values to get the error in prediction. So final data one dollar actual minus final data one dollar predicted. And I will store this in an object called as error one. Okay, so let me have a glance at this view of error one. So this is the error in prediction, guys. Now I'll also bind this error back to the same data set. Again, C bind of final data one, I will bind it with the error column and I will store it back to the final data one object. View of final data one. Now let's see what do we get. So these are the actual values of the tenure. These are the predicted values of the tenure. And this is the error in prediction. Right. So now we can find the root mean square error. So let's do that. Final data one dollar error one. So first I'll take the square of all of the errors. Right. Now after this, I need to take the mean. So let me type in mean over here, following which I need to find out the square root. So I'll type sqrt. So it's root mean square error. Okay. So the RMSE value which we get for the model which we built is 16. So I will store this in RMSE 1, right? So we built a model and we've performed an accuracy check and we found out that the RMSE value with respect to this model is 16. Now what we'll do is we'll build another multiple regression model with different set of independent variables and we'll try to determine which of the models is more accurate. Okay. So this time the independent variables which I'll be taking would be partner, phone service, total charges and payment method. Okay. So again, let me use the LM function and again tenure would be the dependent variable and the independent variables are partner, then we have phone service, for language we have total charges, then the final column would be payment method, right? So we are trying to understand how does tenure vary with respect to partner, phone service, total charges and payment method, and I will store this in mod 2. Okay. Right, before that we would also have to give the data set, so data would be train. So we have built the second model. Now we'll also do the prediction. So predict, I'll give in the first parameter which is the model which you just built, then this prediction needs to be on the test set and I will store all of the values in result. Okay, so this time I'll bind the actual values from the test set, which is test dollar tenure, that is the tenure column from the test set, and the predicted values which are stored in result 2. Again, I will name this column as actual. The second column I'll name it as predicted. Right? So now I will store this in an object called as final data 2. Let me have a glance at this view of final data 2. So guys, these are the actual values of the customer's tenure and these are the predicted values of the customer's tenure. Okay. So again, we'll go ahead and find out the error. Then we'll find the RMSE value. Okay. So before that, we need to convert this to a data frame. So as dot data frame of final data 2, and I will store it back to final data 2. Right, so this is also done. So it's finally time to get our errors. Final data 2 dollar actual minus final data 2 dollar predicted. And I will store this in error 2. Now I'll bind this error back to the same data set. So C bind of final data 2. And I will bind the error back to the same data set. Okay. And I will store it back to the same data set, which will be final 2. So guys, these are the actual values of the customer's tenure. These are the predicted values of the customer's tenure. And this column gives us the error in prediction. So again, we'll go ahead and find out the RMSE value. So final data 2 dollar error 2. Then I will find the square of this. After which we'll get the mean. Then after finding the mean, we'd have to take the square root. SQRT. And I will store this in RMSE 2. So just so that I can create the suspense. Right, so first I will show you guys the value of RMSE 1, which is 16. Now there is something interesting over here. Now RMSE 2, we get NA. Now we've got this NA because there are some NA values already present in the total charges column. Okay, so I'm reiterating guys. So since there are already some NA values present in the total charges column, that is why the RMSE value we've got as NA. So to remove that, we need to use na.rm equals true. So let's do that. I'll type na.rm equals true. So this time the RMSE value which we get is 12.80. Okay. So RMSE 1 is 16 and RMSE 2 is 12.8. So this basically means that the second model which we built is much better than the first model. Again, because it's a simple explanation over here, RMSE 2 is lower than RMSE 1, and that is why the second model is much better than the first model. So if we ever want to select 4 columns to determine the tenure of the customer, then it'll be better to select partner, phone service, total charges and payment method. Okay, so this was a multiple linear regression guys. And this brings us to the end of the session. Thanks for attending and let's meet in the next class.